I'm worried about little Dilbert. He's not like other kids.
What do you mean?
Yesterday, I left him alone for a minute, and he disassembled the TV, our clock, and the stereo.
That's perfectly normal. Kids take things apart.
Oh! The part that worries me is he used the components to build a ham radio set.
Oh, dear.
Is that bad?
Normally, I'd want to run an EEG on him, but the machine isn't working. It's worse than I feared.
What is it?
I'm afraid your son has the knack.
The knack?
The knack. It's a rare condition characterized by an extreme intuition about all things mechanical and electrical, and utter social ineptitude.
Can he lead a normal life?
No. He'll be an engineer. There.
Oh, update on Elijah's chicks. They're all doing real well. Start seeing some eggs. Actually, I'm getting a couple eggs. I picked up a few little leghorns, a couple white leghorns, and a one-barred rock that's already laying. But I think I got 30 hens now, and I got 3 roosters. And most of the hens will start laying around the middle of April. And it's getting to the end of February, so they're doing good. They were hungry. Enjoying this weather. It's been a cold winter. They seem to be doing real well. Chickens are just a great source of protein. These are a heavy breed. You can obviously can eat these too. And when they turn to get older, they make good soup. But the best thing about chickens, of course, is the wonderful egg. And looking forward to a couple dozen a day. It'll be great. We use the rest of the regular water, galvanized water. They work well for years. Got a little story I'll share about these waters. Again, I've always had chickens, and let's see if this one will peck out. Oh yeah, the rooster's getting feisty. growing up, it was my job, well, my brothers and our job to take care of the chickens in the morning. And my mother worked late as a waitress, quite a few 6 days a week, and one morning before school, my brother and I got in a big fight over who was gonna water the chickens that morning. Well, that was the morning that the water saved my life. My mother came flying out of the house with a stick that was whittled by my stepfather to give us a nice beating before school, and I held up the water bucket to deflect the weapon, and my mother proceeded to break the stick over the water bucket, and I took off running. But my poor brother, the stick was left with a very sharp edge, and he got stabbed with our spanking stick. So I took off, got on a bus, went to school, and my brother held his side all day. So anyway, silly chicken story from my childhood. I've always had these chickens, and I've enjoyed them. But I don't know if my brother does, but I think he has chickens now too. So it didn't ruin him. Anyway, just a silly story. Here are my chickens out in their yard. Got this I'm not a big fan of chain link, but this was free. And so just built a little pen about, oh, I guess it's 16 by 20. And so they're pretty happy. Some tree branches fell down. I just left them in there. They enjoy pecking away at those white pines. And so that's my chicken yard. Free chicken yard. Just one more thing on my chickens. You know, me and my water, so I had to have some redundancies. I do have this line, which I have off right now, is used for during the winter. I have it drained down, but this is it's getting warm enough now where I can start using this, and I'm going to set this up with an automatic water. But this is the water from my spring, from my solar pump. And then over here I've got water from, it's actually city water if I need to use it, but I don't like to use it. That's a redundancy. I also can hook into that line with my jet pump from the spring water and pressurize the water to this point. This one's gravity fed, got about 10 PSI, which is just plenty for taking care of the needs of the chickens. And so I'll have that working here pretty soon. Right now, again, like I said, you can see the it's off, it's drained down, so it wouldn't freeze through the winter. But looking forward to just having an automatic water set up for them and make sure that they have plenty of good spring water. And I guess water's the most important thing that you can give to your chickens, besides good food and a clean coop and a yard to run in and play in. And I guess that's it on chickens. So this was the very first thing I built when I moved to the retreat, was the chicken coop. It was 1995, and it's still serving us well. I actually built it on skids. You see this crazy pipe here? I actually drug it out here with a tractor. I built it in a different location, but it got a little too heavy. Anyway, this was the first thing that I built here on our retreat, and still serving us well. I also used the chicken tractor from time to time, and that is getting a little old too, but it has worked great. I'll show you my chicken tractor. Boy, is it is getting old. Obviously I don't have any chickens in it right now, but I picked this thing up. Somebody had it. I didn't even build this. Just paid $100 for it, and I put some new wood here and there on it, but it worked well. We've raised meat chickens in this, and I basically move this throughout the pasture. You know, I'll move it once a week, and it's a great way to raise free-range chickens for meat. So, though it looks rough, it still works great. Good morning, girls.